This is the Nissan Leaf's gauge cluster, right? We'll go from left to right so I can briefly explain what it is you're looking at. Over here on the left is the battery temperature gauge. This is something that should never be much of an issue for most people, primarily because the battery tends to run right around ambient temp, plus a few degrees C. Okay? Let's move to the right. Over here down the middle, you see the trip computer, essentially. There are selectable screens. You could look at your odometer, your efficiency, but one of the key things you're looking at here is at the vehicle's current state of charge, how much time will it take to fully charge it based on 240 volt level 2 charging, or of course level 1 charging, which is the 120 volt. Right above that, you see this green icon. Essentially, in quiet vehicles like hybrids or electric vehicles, possibly even fuel cell vehicles, it is basically an indication that the vehicle is ready to move. If you put it in reverse, it will go in reverse. What's directly above that? You see these spheres or bubbles. Right now, that position is it's at rest. This is technically a power meter. Right now, there is no power being used. If you were to accelerate or step on the accelerator pedal, the bubbles would kind of populate towards the right all the way to the very end. That very last bubble represents the full 80 kilowatt output of the motor. Then, of course, if you're coasting or braking, it will go here to the left. You see that kind of circular double arrow deal right there? That's basically showing a kind of energy coming back into the car. That's regen. Over here you have the state of charge meter. Essentially, the vehicle, it's the equivalent of looking at your gas gauge. How much you have left. Right now, it looks like there's about one bar missing. Maybe you're at around 95%, 90%, something like that. And then, directly below that, is the distance to empty meter. It is important to note that this distance to empty meter says 87 miles, but it could also read 70 miles at this same state of charge. What makes it different? Well, that's essentially how you have been driving. The distance to empty meter is essentially an instantaneous readout of how much range you will get should you continue to drive in the fashion you've been driving for the last 5 miles, whatever it may be. So a good segue is, how do you really know you're driving that efficiently outside, you know, outside of that distance to empty meter? Over here to the left of this top part of the gauge is essentially an eco meter. Notice that that's that semi-circular gauge over there. It's only got a few bars in there. If we were moving, that's a dynamic gauge. If you are driving efficiently, it will fill all the way up to the top. And then if you're going wide open throttle, it would kind of look at the way it's looking now. Okay. Now, as you drive, and you drive more efficiently, you will actually see little segments of trees growing right underneath that eco meter, let's say. And then right next to that, of course, is the speedometer. Vehicle's top speed is supposed to be 90 miles per hour. Some people have said otherwise and have proven otherwise, but there's no reason to go that fast.